Deep treated spot after CO2 laser and wetting in 2 weeks. Is it supposed to look like this after CO2 laser? Hi, I went to a clinic due to a sunspot on my cheek. Doctor said it was a lentigo, and doctor suggested CO2 laser treatment. They told me the recovery time is around 1 week, so I went for it. Now, it is 24 days later, my wound still looks red, and the worst part is it looks deep. I have been taking care of the wound carefully, without any complication after the procedure. Since the spot is so deep, will it leave a scar in the future? And how long should I wait to see the result? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. You submitted 3 photos, and in your question you describe a situation where you had a solar lentigo treated using a CO2 laser approximately 24 days earlier. And with the photos you submitted, you are drawing attention to an area where you say it's still red and that it looks relatively deep. And you're asking about what to expect from this situation. And apparently this is very close to a very important event, a wedding. So certainly I can give you some guidance as to my thoughts as to your situation. And I understand that this is in the absence of physical examination, as well as knowing some other details about your situation, including the laser and the type of treatment, energies, etc., that were applied. Just a little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and I can tell you that I've been using the CO2 laser since the original CO2 lasers since the mid-90s. And I can certainly give you a little bit of guidance as to my thoughts. But before that, just to understand, your problem was a solar lentigo. And essentially a solar lentigo is a well-defined, basically brown spot that is at a certain level in the skin called the dermal-epidermal junction. And basically it's consistent solar associated with sun, and it's a concentration of pigment cells that cause these brown discolorations. Now the modalities to treat solar lentigos essentially cover several different potential options. But in principle, you can treat solar lentigos with something like what we did years ago, with as straightforward as a chemical peel, such as a TCA peel or trichloroacetic acid peel, or even a more superficial peel. But you can, and of course, you can also use thermal energy devices that translate or transfer light energy into heat energy. This includes modalities such as intense pulse light treatment, as well as lasers such as erbium and CO2 laser. So in your situation, just looking at the degree of your the defect in your skin, which looks like a little crescent shape, I would express some concern. And I think that first of all, you should be communicating with your doctor. It's 24 days since the procedure, and there had to be certain thoughts involved in why your doctor chose CO2 laser, and what was the recommendation as far as aftercare for the treatment. You stated in your question that it was anticipated that your recovery period would be in about 1 week. Well, judging from the level and depth that appears on the photo, I am concerned that the epidermis or the epithelial part of the healing is just not closing in, and that appears to be some depth to this which would concern me about the healing of the dermis. You see, the differentiations you make when you are making a decision like this has several variables when it comes to choosing the modality for a procedure like this. The modality such as pulse light treatment is to focus in on the actual pigment or the melanin And procedures that require ablation is like literally taking off that top layer of skin. And in concept, basically the body generates new skin that will be continuous and smooth. So when you apply a device such as a CO2 laser, you are getting relatively deep penetration of heat. Now that effect of heat on re-epithelialization or repair is certainly an important factor. And what was done in the aftercare of your skin is also a factor. My concern is that you might end up with a slight depression in your skin based on this set of photos. So you need to meet with your doctor. Your doctor should be able to give you guidance as to what to do. One of the complications of laser treatment is this type of situation where you can have this type of defect or problems with healing. Problems with healing can include problems with crust that forms, problems with inflammation, problems with infection. There are a lot of things that can be factored in. So we don't have to automatically think that the laser itself, and when you think about the term CO2 laser, there's many variables as to the level of energy and the depth in which you can apply this energy. So I think you need to meet with your doctor. I think that as a specialist who's done this for many years, my concern is, will you be able to have proper healing long-term, or can you do something to improve the appearance without getting an indentation? So it is 24 days after the procedure. There is still wound healing going on, but usually, from my experience, the epithelium will have healed well enough that you wouldn't see a depression. Now, your doctor may have done multiple passes because they felt that the level of the pigment may have been a little bit deeper. Again, not being there and not knowing the parameters and your situation, it's a little bit difficult. But this is where the communication with the doctor is critical. Understand what happened, and maybe your doctor could intervene to help reduce the situation as well as do something to help improve the healing process. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.